everybody! Welcome to Event Answer, and today I'm going to share with you how I put together this woodland-themed baby shower. It's been such a delight to put it together, and I can't wait to share with you all the steps that I did to make this happen. This is actually the first video in a series that I'll be doing all this month, and I'll cover the various steps it took to put together this party. The next video will be about the backdrop and the table decorations. The second video will be about this lovely diaper cake and how you can make one for yourself in various themes, and a little diaper centerpiece. So not only will these decorate your baby shower, but they'll also be a very practical gift for your mother-to-be. The final video will be how I put together all the treats on this table. So I'll be walking you through all of those steps so you can have a complete baby shower ready to go in a matter of a couple videos. Today I'm going to show you how I put all of this together in a montage, but while that's going on, I'm going to give you a couple tips on how to plan a baby shower and work with your mother-to-be to create a lovely party. So stick around and see how this happened! When you're planning a baby shower, make sure you sit down and have a good conversation with the mother-to-be and find out some of the preferences she has and the expectations she has for this party. The first thing you need to figure out is when to have the party. You can have it before the baby is born, which is your traditional baby shower. You get together and celebrate the baby-to-be when they're not there. The second is more of a sip and see. So once the baby arrives, usually a couple weeks or a month or so after the baby arrives, you have a party and the guests can come and meet the newborn versus just kind of talking about them. Once you know that, you can pick a date with your mother-to-be on when to have the party. Another thing you want to ask your mother-to-be is if she has any themes or particular animals or anything that they are decorating for the nursery or are getting for the child. So a lot of people will pick like a woodland theme or a spaceship theme or a certain animal like a baby elephant to either decorate the nursery or give a first toy to, or kind of the clothing and accessory style. A lot of times people pick a theme. And you can take that theme idea from the parent and bring it into the baby shower. So either you can theme the entire baby shower around that, or it can kind of come in subtle hints, because not only will you be able to make things for the baby shower, you might get double use out of it and have it be a decoration or a gift for the new child once they arrive. A good example of that is this baby sign behind me. So this makes a really fun backdrop, but you could also hang it above the crib once the child arrives. Another thing that you can do is if you decorate with stuffed toys that the child would have. So I've got this squirrel here, which fits the theme for the baby shower, but would also make a great first toy once the child arrives. Another thing you want to find out from the mother-to-be is what is her expectation for the party? Does she just intend this to be a general come and go, meet up with family and friends maybe they haven't seen in a while, you know, have a few munchies, and just kind of generally chat with people? Or is she expecting a full-blown, planned out itinerary for the party? You know, are you going to be playing kooky games like putting chocolate in diapers and hiding babies in people's drinks? Are you going to be doing diaper changing challenges? You know, if this is something that your mother-to-be is expecting, you need to keep that in mind as you're planning. So whether it's a come and go kind of casual affair or if it's a planned out itinerary, make sure you have that in mind ahead of time and you can plan accordingly. A tip I have is the mother-to-be should not be stressed about this party. Usually it's you, a friend, a sister, someone is planning the party usually for the mother-to-be. And so it's your job to be the hero of the day and make it so that the mom doesn't have to worry about anything. She just arrives at the party, has a wonderful time, and gets to leave. You know, she should not be lifting boxes or setting up little things. You know, unless that's something that she loves doing, this is your responsibility and take the ball and run with it. So try and get all of your details sorted out ahead of time. If you need to convince other people to help you with setup or making food or helping prepare the space that the party will be planned in, get all those details worked out ahead of time. And that reduces not only your stress, but the stress on the mother-to-be. really, I want you to have fun. You know, parties do not have to be a burden. With a little bit of planning ahead of time and some fun little looks, you can have a wonderful party and it doesn't have to be stressful. So have fun, make some fun things, eat some wonderful food, and celebrate the birth of a new life. I hope you found this video inspirational. It's so much fun to put together this woodland themed baby shower, and I can't wait to share with you even more steps in future videos. So all this month, I'll be releasing a new video on Fridays to give you the next step in this series. So make sure you hit the subscription button below and turn on that notification bell so you won't miss the next step in this series. If you're watching this in the future, I will add these to the cards and in the description box below as future videos get added to this series and put those together in a playlist for you so you won't miss them in the future. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in a future video. Bye!